Mr. Rudy, obviously there's a focus on agriculture and rural sectors, 9 great ideas outlined by the finance minister at the beginning. But there are some questions about the fact that how is the implementation of all of this going to work, especially the simplification, and some fresh questions arising in areas like Provident Fund and whether withdrawal will now start being taxable, at least 60% of it. Mr. Rudy?
Yeah, tell me. Yeah, I just missed the last bit of it.
Yeah, so I'm just asking you for your comments on the budget before we go across. Mr. Jaitley who's having a press conference. Yeah.
Hey, overall, if you see that, I was just hearing Vrindal, so that is the left way of looking at the budget. I never found an occasion ever in my lifetime when they would have appreciated anything. But the, this budget focuses completely on the poor, the farmers, the rural sector, the youth, the unemployed. So the focus has been very agrarian, and the second focus has been the infrastructure in which we are spending about. You see the situation when we are talking about certain issues, the choice was between the corporate world making investment, facilitating their investment, but they're already under stress, A, because of global reasons, B, because of their own doings in the past, that there is a large stress asset which has been created. Now, I don't want to get into that. But the choice with the government was to create more public spending. And I think the government chose to do large public spending without becoming inflationary or without without getting into the fiscal deficit part of it and trying to retain the fiscal deficit to bring it down to 3.5, which was as mandated. Now, right. Whether it was in the irrigation sector where we're spending about 40,000 crores, whether it is the rural roads where we're spending about 27,000 crores largest, whether it's, if you look into the poor, where the health insurance has been given to all the 25 crores BPL, and those above 60 would get 1,30,000 rupees, those below less than 60 would 1 lakh. The gas connection which goes to the poor now, which is about 5 crores in the next 3 years, which is something phenomenal. So you see, this is a balanced budget where a lot of focus has been, even trying to see the rationalization of subsidy through the Aadhaar portal or Aadhaar framework is where the pilot project on fertilizer subsidy has also been decided. So there are many areas in which innovation has been done, even in the tax reforms, which more than 55 lakh crores have been pending in appeals and disputes. So a redressal mechanism has been created there, which would facilitate the process of getting out of those appeals. So I think,
Mr. Rudy, if I could come in here, this is Shweta.
Tax
system, I have a very pointed question to you. Mr. Rudy, as a skill development minister, I have a very pointed question to you. How much fillip has this budget given to job creation at a time when the entire focus has really been on public spending? But when it comes to boosting private sector investment, we're not sure how much this budget has been able to achieve. I mean, do you think the private sector can come out confidently after this budget, open up their purse strings and say we're ready to invest?
Well, that has been, as I said in the very beginning, there is a visible stress in the private sector. And for that, to boost investments, we have talked about certain incentives in the housing sector. We are talking about great investment in the infrastructure sector, which would possibly kickstart the economy in a big way. So we have proposed it. We are aware, and the finance minister very categorically said that he does not expect much private funds to be flowing in, for maybe because of the reasons globally, or maybe because huge investments for whatever reason over the years has been gone into stress or their NPS. So that is an issue which the government is, and that is why recapitalization of the banks, the government has planned to give them about 25,000 crores. Government has also planned to merge the banks today to make it more viable and to make it more functionally viable. So all these things have
but
been
Mr.
proposed.
Rudy, but the money which has been announced for that, Mr. Rudy, the money, 25,000 towards bank recapitalization, this is what many people thought is a major crisis area. And it's because the banks have got NPAs, they can't lend that much. Corporates are stuck there, for so it's this twin balance sheet problem. Corporates are indebted and they can't invest. With 25,000 crore rupee in bank recapitalization and the other measures that have been done, is it enough to really
Well, I agree with you. was this budget, this budget could not have been, I'm sorry for it, the budget could not have been solely to bail out the banks, because their assets have gone NPAs or the investments have gone NPAs, and that is why the government chose a path of public spending, keeping the fiscal deficit in taking it into account, and we have done it. So I understand that this particular stress which you are talking, the choice was the government to incentivize or write off huge amounts of money for reasons best known by the previous governments or the people who have invested. So this is a big debate which will definitely happen in the country. But I'm happy that the Prime Minister had a clear focus that this budget would be centrally focused on the rural areas, on irrigation, on infrastructure, on roads, on connectivity, on all that matters in the rural economy. So I think the focus was clear, and this was the conscious choice of the government. So the people may argue, where would the employment get, where would the investment come? So I think this is a debate which we have to see, and this is a conscious call by the government, and I think we will have to take that call that this is a choice of the government.
All right, Mr. Rudy, well, thank you so much for joining us. We're going to slip into a break right now, and then after that, my colleague